Is there any such thing as sin? When you work homicides, or for the years I worked burglaries and robberies before I worked homicides, these are wrongdoings, right? I mean, we would say in our culture that these are things you ought not do. It's interesting when I hear people kind of react with hesitation about the term sin, quote unquote. A lot of people I know would reject this idea altogether. There's no such thing as sin, at least not in an objective sense. There's just this kind of a group opinion about what's right or wrong in any given situation. But how can we really call that really wrong, to call something sin? Why is it we reject or are hesitant about adopting such a notion? You know, when we talk about sin from a biblical perspective, it's this idea of an archer that is pulling back his bow and releasing that arrow, and it flies toward the target, but it doesn't hit the bullseye. It misses it by some small margin. That miss, that slightly off the mark result of where the arrow lands, this is kind of the concept that we use when we talk about sin. It's missing the mark. And I think I know a lot of people, especially the people I take to jail, who have a real hesitance to even identify their behavior as sin. But if we're going to reject the notion of sin, what we're really rejecting is the notion of a bullseye. Because sin is simply this idea of missing the bullseye. Are we ready to reject bullseyes, moral bullseyes, as a community, as a culture, as a country? If we remove the bullseyes, we can get rid of this idea of sin. Because sin is simply just being off the mark a small bit or a large bit. But are we really willing to remove all moral bullseyes? I think most of us would recognize that, yeah, all the human endeavor is us trying to bend our knee toward the moral bullseye. Let's be careful about the notion of removing bullseyes just so we can eradicate the notion of sin. Yeah, sin exists because we know the importance of moral bullseyes. Now, let me give you another way to think about this. I think there's another reason why people resist the notion of sin. We don't resist the notion of crimes. We would say there are things we agree. Some things are criminal, are bad behaviors. Crimes, we are okay with the idea, the notion of crimes. We can all accept that. But we hesitate when it comes to this idea of sin. Why? Well, crimes are simply a violation of human law. But this notion of sin is much deeper than that, right? It's really a violation of God's law. And I think sometimes the reason why we resist the notion of sin is because we really resist the notion of God. When we violate human laws, we commit crimes. When we violate God's law, we are involved in sin. Now, it turns out that God's law also encompasses all those human laws, right? So if you're going to violate a human law, you're also violating God's law. Although you could violate God's law and not violate a human law at all. For example, it's still legal in this country for people to commit adultery. But that's a law that God says he still honors. That's still a law that he wants us to obey. I think part of the reason why we are hesitant toward the notion of sin is because we are hesitant toward the notion of accountability with the holy God. And when we violate the laws of the holy God, we now know that is called sin. So let's be honest about what it is. We embrace the idea of crime. We believe there are some notions, some things you should not do. Well, God believes that too. Really, your hesitancy toward embracing the concept of sin really is rooted in your hesitancy in believing in the existence of God. But let me give you one last way to think about this. Look, we agree that if we're going to define sin in this way, as this transgression against a holy God, then in some ways, like we said before, we're really just saying, if I deny there is sin, I'm really saying I deny there's a God. Because these two things are necessary. Without a God, we can call it a crime, but can we call it a sin, really? So when we say, I don't believe there's any sin, we're really saying, I don't believe there's any God. But it turns out there are many good reasons to believe that God exists. There are good reasons to believe, by looking at the evidence in our universe, that God exists, that we're in a universe that appears to be fine-tuned for life, that life actually emerges unbelievably, miraculously, unexplainably from non-life. And then when it does emerge, it appears to be designed, as though a designer is involved in the process of life in the universe. We have good reasons. Even the information that's in DNA is best attributed to the mind of a creator, because you can't get that kind of information in DNA from physics. You can't get that from chemistry. Look, there are good reasons to believe that there is a God. And if there's a God, then we're kind of stuck with the notion of sin, right? Because the only reason why we're rejecting sin is because we reject the existence of God. Let's think about that for a second. Don't allow your emotional responses to the notion of sin override your intellectual reasoning about the existence of God.